But what if you wanted to call a function, and it didn't happen to be stored as a property of the object that you want the parameter this to be bound to? So imagine this function looks great, but the keyword this is supposed to refer to a specific object, and that specific object doesn't have this function as a property. There would be no way in that situation to address this function as the given object dot anything. If this isn't stored as a property, there's no key you can use on that object in order to access the function. Besides the left of the dot rule that we just described, there's actually another way for you to specify the value that you'd like the parameter this to get bound to. Let's make a copy of that previous line, which had the effect of assigning global as the default binding for this. And we'll edit the line with an attempt to specify exactly what we'd like this function to bind the keyword this to. By using a functions.call method, we get to override the default binding to global and override the left of the dot rule. In this case, we'll pass in any value we want, and it'll get bound to the keyword this. When using .call, we pass in one extra value at the beginning of the argument list, and that value will be bound to the parameter this. So what would happen if we used .call on a function that was also being accessed as a property? Here, we're using .call to pass in this new yellow object, but that method was already found as a property of the red object.